succeeds.
No, she doesn't. Don't look through it.
Curious. A little late.
Where are we?
What is this?
It's the same.
Different.
It's another world. It's lighter.
It's nicer. I like it here.
Can we stay?
The bridge. It's not broken.
It's fixed.
I didn't realize it was broken. I just decided to try that. Alright, so that doesn't open from this side.
Didion is in there. Don't forget.
You can fear me.
You need the runes to fight.
You need Dillion.
I know, guys.
He's waiting for you.
He always said he would wait.
He's close.
He cares about you.
You can feel he's close. He loves you. Oh, calling you. Dillion. Dillion, we're here.
Dillion.
We're nearly here. We're here. Dillion,
there he is.
What are you waiting for?
Quick, find a way.
Find him.
Go through
before he disappears.
Dillion, don't lose him.
Where is he?
Where's he gone?
We're in the wrong world.
He's not here.
She's in the wrong world.
Shut up, voices.
He's in the dark world.
The dark.
The dark.
The world once seemed so simple. Black and white. Darkness and light. Narrow dividing lines of our own making. Dillion taught her to see further. To peek through the cracks and see the worlds of color stretching away from the gloom. And Senua explored new paths into the unknown.
He didn't believe
you
that
can't go up there.
You can't go up there.
Not in this.
When everyone else turned their backs.
You can't.
The Northmen tell this story about the death of Baldur. It begins with dark dreams. Night after night, Baldur dreams of his own death, and the gods fear for his life. So Baldur's mother makes everything in the world, fire, water, iron, stone, earth, wood, beasts, birds, serpents, poison, sickness, swear an oath not to harm her sons. One by one, they each make their vow.
Right there.
Neither weapons nor wood will injure him, Baldur's mother boasts. Only Loki, father of Hela, the mistress of death, is not amused.
Why is this not enough? There it goes.
Senua! You've got it.
Why isn't he here?
He cared in a way that nobody else did.
He's in the dark world.
He's gone to the dark world.
You're in the wrong world.
Relax.
He's in the other world.
Wait,
dark world. Without you.
He's the reason she's alive at all.
The voices are driving me crazy. I can't imagine. Open the door.
Dillion.
gods feast and rejoice and amuse themselves by throwing spears and stones at Baldur, striking at him with sword and axe. But he comes to no harm, whatever they do. The gods never cease to wonder at this great marvel. But Loki shapes himself into a woman and asks Baldur's mother, "Is it really true that all things promise to keep him safe?" "I did not ask the mistletoe," Baldur's mother confesses. "I thought it was too young." Oh dear.
See, I know Loki kills him with the mistletoe.
Cursed.
Years had passed since she left her father. She trained hard alongside her friend. Dillian.
Was it worth it?
She saw things no one else could. Patterns. Shapes. Movement. An intuition that made her an exceptional warrior. Friendship turned to love. But the shadow of darkness never let her go, and she was caught between two worlds.
Yours alive and Dillian's dead.
Her sin bells that have passed.
How does that make you feel?
And Dillian. A future. Two realities.
Those rune things down there.
Get in the way if they are just to tire you out, make you weak before the battle.
Loki makes a dart out of mistletoe and goes to the gods as they throw things at Baldur. The blind god, Hood, was there. Loki asks him why he wasn't taking part. Hood says, "I cannot see where Baldur stands, and even if I could see him, I have no weapon." Loki replies, "Here is a wand. I will tell you where he stands." And Hoth throws the mistletoe at Baldur. It pierces through him, and to everyone's horror, Baldur is killed. And for this, Hoth is slain.
Well, poor Hoth. Alright, let's look through this mask.
He was the only one that didn't mind the curse. He loved her so much.
It's obviously this right here, but I gotta get the right angle.
Dillian saved you from them.
What if they're all about wasting your time just delaying? Do you like minute?
His love is everything.
What does she think she's doing?
You're special.
She thinks she...
They mean nothing.
The gods are just
toying away. Clay touched you.
What if the gods are laughing?
in a way that nobody else did. Do you remember how he made you feel?
Yeah, I gotta go that way somehow.
He led you astray.
You should have listened to your father when you had the chance.
Why didn't you listen to him?
This love has tortured you,
and it tortures me.
Shut up, y'all.
Do you remember the way he stroked your hair? Do you remember the way...
The Northmen tell how the gods mourned Baldur. His body was to be burnt on his ship, but they could not manage to push it into the sea and sent for a giantess to do it. She comes riding a wolf and has vipers for her wings. She pushes Baldur's ship into the sea with such force that the ground shakes and the rollers burst into flames. When Baldur's wife sees his body carried onto the ship, her heart bursts with grief, and she dies. She's put next to her husband, and the pyre is lit, sending the dead to hell. But even so, the gods cannot accept his death.
Could she trust him? You have no chance of love.
Nobody will love you again.
Ever.
Again.
Overcome with grief, the gods send Hermod to ride to Hel and ask Hela to let Baldur return home. All the gods are weeping, he says. Are they? Asks Hela. We shall see if he is truly missed. If everything in the world will weep for him, he shall go back to the gods. But if even one thing refuses, Baldur stays with me. The gods send messengers everywhere. Weep for Baldur, weep him out of hell. And everything wept. Men, beasts, earth, stone, trees, metal, everything. Except for a giantess they found in a cave. Baldur was never my friend, she says. Let hell keep what she has. The Northmen say that the giantess must have been Loki in disguise.
Runes. You see runes everywhere.
Everywhere.
But what if they're not real? What if they don't actually make sense? The gods were lying.
Thinking.
The gods are playing with you.
It makes sense in your mind, but it doesn't make sense.
Worlds.
The gods.
But it doesn't mean anything.
You can't read this language. You don't understand.
Senua.
Dillion never much cared for the underworld, and looked dimly upon the druids, like her father, Zinbel. I guess he